Elon Musk's Neuralink is straight out of Black Mirror, with the goal of allowing you to send a text with just your thoughts. But this brain chip has a controversial side, from animal abuse to the possibility of chips being hacked, the dystopian idea of humans becoming one with artificial intelligence, and the unknown impacts on our brains. From Twitter to Tesla, Elon Musk seems to be everywhere, but your brain might just be his next profitable business. To understand how he could do this, let's go back to the beginning. Neuralink, founded in 2016, is one of Musk's most controversial companies, developing brain chips to implant in people's skulls. The chip technology works by being inserted in the brain behind the ear. It's roughly the size of a coin, and tiny wires and electrodes embed themselves and fan out inside the brain. These little wires have over 1,000 electrodes to record and potentially stimulate brain activity. All of the data would connect from the chip in the brain to computers for research, basically downloading your brain activity onto a PC. Musk has repeatedly compared it to the Fitbit of the brain and says the ultimate goal is to have a product that combines AI and the human experience that works to prevent or treat neurological disorders. He's gone as far as claiming it could one day cure autism. Neuralink has been positioned as a technology that could help those struggling with disabilities to increase their access to everyday activities, with the first chip potentially going to quadriplegic people. This would theoretically allow them to control technology with their mind, even sending a text with a simple thought, according to a tweet from Musk. These goals are lofty, and while they do seem well-intentioned, that isn't the full story. There's a dark side, because technologies like this come at a cost. In 2020, Gertrude the pig was one of the first animals to be showcased wearing Neuralink. With the chip inserted, they were able to predict her exact steps on a treadmill. They also tracked her brain as she did different activities, resulting in these beeping sounds that indicate nerve reaction. But if the eventual goal is for implants to be in humans, there had to be more test subjects than Gertrude. And she wasn't the only animal that had her skull cut open in this risky surgery. This monkey's name is Pager. He's one of 23 macaque monkeys that were used in the 2017 to 2020 experiments in collaboration between University of California, Davis and Neuralink. In this video, you see him controlling a game with his mind. And while everything looks normal, there's a different picture painted by animal rights organization Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine, or PCRM.
And that's where things get grim.
PCRM put forward a complaint to the U.S. Department of Agriculture claiming that the 23 monkeys experienced extreme suffering during experimentation. The group based the findings on more than 700 pages of documents obtained through a public record request from UC Davis. The documents had everything from veterinary and necropsy reports, and PCRM stated that at least 15 of the monkeys died or were euthanized by 2020. Neuralink and UC Davis have now admitted to euthanizing 8 animals. But they paint a different picture, saying there was no suffering and everything was up to code.
After 2020, Neuralink created their own vivarium for further testing and cut ties with UC Davis.
But the goal is for Neuralink to reach the human mind. And Musk is taking it to the next level, saying progress will accelerate when we have the devices in humans next year. And Neuralink has some competition. Synchron, another chip company, beat them to the human trial stage when they implanted a device in the first person this summer. While Musk is making promises of getting devices into humans soon, Neuralink hasn't even gotten approval for human trials from the FDA yet. There won't be any real data about how Neuralink works in humans until the first test subject volunteers. But perhaps people are not asking enough questions about the potential implications. Like, what if a chip malfunctions? Being so close to the brain, what would happen if an infection occurs? Are the risks of brain surgery worth the result? Or perhaps scariest of all, if hackers got into the brain chip, what would that mean for a person's behavior or health? It's hard to fathom these futuristic, hypothetical situations, but they aren't unrealistic. And if this is going to be inserted in the heads of humans, they're questions that need answers. Well, the project is a couple years behind, with Musk originally saying he wanted implants in humans by 2020. The next date to look out for, though, is November 30th for his upcoming show-and-tell event where he should be giving updates on the project. He sees a future where we download memories and thoughts to play back, or telepathically summon our cars. It all sounds very futuristic and Black Mirror, and potentially unrealistic according to many experts. So far, the monkey experimentation hasn't shown anything particularly new or different from studies in the past.
Knowing that, we have to ask ourselves, are the risks and potential suffering worth an outcome that's unknown or even out of reach? So what do you think about Neuralink? Will you be lining up to get one when it's ready? Let us know in the comments below, and I'll see you in the future.